Yeah, I thought I'd put a couple words in about the CDL. I was helping this girl today. I really enjoyed being a teacher, a trainer, U.S. Express, over at PetSmart. She was trying to deliver a load of dog food or something in Jenkintown. So she had to get in there. It was a long tunnel of a dock in the inside of a building. And it was a strict 90-degree turn to get into this tunnel. She wanted me to do it, and I would have done it, but I needed to take a pit break first. I did. I got back to showing her how to serpentine it backwards. And that's why I wanted to say something. I didn't really plan to get started working in the industry until I practiced the reverse serpentine. It's the only good way to be able to back up reliably. I mean, to know you can back up reliably. Reverse serpentine, yeah. With an 8-foot trailer, or a 16-foot trailer, or a 53-foot trailer. Angelo, come this way, good boy. So, I want to get my motorcycle hauler sooner or later. It won't be long. And that's my plan. To keep doing those reverse serpentines one after the other for a long period of time, because if you can do a reverse serpentine, and I don't like to say it, but a 90 degree alley dock under power, or a 45 degree alley dock under power, or a parallel park under power, that's these truck rodeo maneuvers, we can handle a trailer really well. A large, bulky trailer reacts slow. Oh, this is a landscape park here. They give out free mulch. If you bring your trailer in here, like an 8-foot. And so that's what I plan to do, is come out here to this landscaper park with my motorcycle hauler. Probably go to Tractor Supply and get one. Practice and practice and practice the reverse serpentine here consistently, right? This place is 200 feet wide at one point, and it's got plenty of places to pull up an alley dock in this park. I'd like to say I was looking for work right now, but you know, I'm not going to do it until I get a little trailer and practice. Get really excellent at it. So if there's someone in the industry looking for me to like show up for their school or position, not ready for it yet. I want to practice my backing up with the little trailer and get really good at it. It's the only way to be sure you'll pass their test, I figure. Yeah, all they're asking for in Pennsylvania is the 45 degree alley dock and the parallel park and straight line backing. But in the larger world, you know, truck stops and local delivery services, it's really necessary to be able to do a 90 degree accurately and alley dock gap. Into like a building or something. And, I'd hate to miss that opportunity. So I need to save up and buy a trailer and just get a trailer for Christmas or something. If I get a trailer, I'll start working towards getting a job again. There's just two things I need to do to become a good trucker, pass my courses. First thing is the yard skills, and the second thing is to be sure I'm good at shifting. It wasn't bad the last time, but I'll take an official refresher course just to check myself on that. And I don't see any problems with a 9-speed, but a 10, I take a little more personal best effort. So I'm not totally confident I passed that the first time. All right, that's what courses are for. where I plan to go. Okay, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.